Hey all, I'm doing a secondary video looking at our use of Slack. This is a little bit more higher functioning. This is to provide some guidance on some, discourse elements, the ways in which we use Slack as a tool to show you what the pros might be doing. So in the earlier video, I talked about how to get started and what the channels are and direct messages and how to edit your profile. This one, we're going to do some more finer tuned elements. So a couple different things that we can take a look at. Once again, let's say I'm in the general section of this specific Slack workspace. I can go in, and if I leave a general message to somebody, I can say, hey everyone, good morning. But then also, if I wanted to notify someone. So this message is for the general channel. Anyone can see and read this. But if I want to make sure that someone in particular sees this message, what I'm going to do is I'm going to mention them in this. I'm going to at them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit the little at symbol, and then I can scroll down. I can look for pretty much everyone there. And so in this instance, I'm going to ping Jen on this. I can say, I hope you have a great start to today. And then I can basically add in a little smiley face. So what this message will do is it will send out the message. Everyone will see it. Jen in particular will receive a notification that someone is talking about her. So if you're having a discussion back and forth, or you want to say something and make sure someone sees it, you can at them. Basically just hit the little symbol and then go find their name. You'll also notice that I have the emoticon saved in there. The emoticon basically will automatically convert for you. If you're having trouble finding things, then you can go over here. There's that little at symbol as well. You can also find a number of emoji and emoticons over here. So I could say rocket and see what's there. Or I can say money. And I can find these. And basically I can click on that and it will add it in right away for me. Other things to note down here, if you want to ping everyone, so if you want to make sure everyone sees it, because sometimes people's notifications are set so they only get direct messages and they sort of ignore everything else, if you say at channel, then what it will do is every single person that has joined this channel will get a notification. So that is like an all call, an all alert to make sure that everybody is seeing this message that you're about to share. A couple other things. Some of you really like formatting pieces here. They use a modified version of Markdown. So what you can do is say good morning. And if you wanted to, you could make this bold. The way that you make it bold is you basically will add in the little asterisks. If I want to make it italicized, so if a part of my message I want to put into italics, I can add that in. Sometimes I'll have people in Slack channels, they will give me a strike through. I think it's a little bit less used, but if you want to like have a sense of humor, you can have say something and strike it through at the same time. You can add in code, pre-format things, or add in quotes. So it depends on what you want to. So there's some formatting. Once again, it's meant to be relatively minimal. So that's different ways to format your message. If I click on this over here, I can upload content from my computer. I can add code. I can add a Google Docs file. Other things that work out pretty well, if you share, you can see people shared links up here. So if I drop that link in, it's going to open it up a little bit and give me a preview of the link. Pretty basic stuff. While we're here in a discussion, let's talk about discussion threads. So Lisa shared this post. If I want to go in, the etiquette for this is to try and leave our content together. So I believe I had in the general section, I asked a question yesterday. Let's see if people responded back to me. So I asked this question here about syntax and Python and coding. And you can see that a couple people responded. One person gave me a thumbs up. So Chad Davis gave me a thumbs up. And then down here, somebody else basically responded back. So one of the things that's really nice is you want to reply in a threaded discussion. And the nice thing about that is it doesn't, add a lot of content to people's feeds. So if somebody wants to see, okay, what were the responses to my question here, I can click on the replies, and then over on the side, I can see Alex said what challenges am I talking about, and then Tiffany had a response, and then Lisa also had a response. So what I can go through is I can say, I can respond directly to Alex here, and I can basically, because it happened a little bit a while ago, I can say at Alex, I was thinking about challenges later as learners learn how to code. So once again, Alex is going to get pinged on this to see what my response was here. But I can also go in and I can basically give a thumbs up or a check mark saying that I read this. I can basically add to the thumbs up that Chad gave it, or I can give it another one. And then I can basically add a comment here. I can say a smiley face, and I can say, Lisa, thanks for the share, and add another smiley face. So threaded discussions makes the discussion forum and Slack a little bit easier to read and take a look at. So I can basically go in and I can leave comments, and it's nice. It's a better way to get around Slack if you use threaded discussions. So if I'm here and there is not a discussion happening already, I can go in and I can look at this. I could just leave a general message here and I could say, hey, Lisa, thanks. But what is better is if I don't leave that message there, if I go in and when I see someone's post, I can add a reaction there. I can star this if I want to save it for later. I can pin this, which means that on this general channel, it'll be pinned to the top so everyone will see it. But for my purposes right now, if I share this, it's going to share it outside of the channel or to another channel. But what I want to do is I want to hit start a thread, and I want to have my response in a threaded discussion. Okay, so please try and use threaded discussions. It makes it a little bit easier for people in Slack to follow along when they don't see a lot of messages and responses back and forth. So another thing I want to take a look at while we're here is the elusive Slackbot. When you get started, Slackbot, depending on the settings for Slack, for the Slack workspace, depending on the settings, Slackbot might be really, really helpful or really, really annoying. But basically, Slackbot is a little animated machine learning bot that's there to try and help you. So Slackbot, if you ask a question, so let's say I'm here over in general, and I can say, hey, Slackbot, I can ask Slackbot a question anywhere within Slack, or I can go right to Slackbot. And if I'm trying to get help, I could say, how do I edit my profile? So Slackbot can respond to that, the question that I have. So basically Slackbot is a way to help you get around and help you make sense of how to use Slack. There are times that Slackbot is a bit annoying, as I said, and other times it helps out. When you get started with Slack and you add things in here, I'm trying to find an example, Slackbot will interject and basically ask, you know, is there a better way to do this for you? So Slackbot's trying to help you. It depends on how much you want to use it. For the most part, I ignore Slackbot. There are times that it will pop up again and again. So we talked about Slackbot. We talked about threaded discussions. There is also an opportunity to share content. So as I was talking about messaging, I talked about I could add a file from Google Drive or my computer. If you're on a mobile device, it's a lot easier to share photos, and I definitely recommend sharing photos. I have another video on how to use iPads and iPhones. So it's when you're trying to get your message across, it's very helpful if you share photos of a whiteboard or post-it notes or your work or student work so that other people can take a look at it. We talked about direct messaging people and having that content back and forth. So I can see Mary Ellen is here. If I'm looking at a discussion, what I might say is, okay, I'm very interested in this post that Lisa shared, but maybe for some reason I don't want to message everyone and let everyone see what I have to say. I might slide over to Lisa's page and direct message Lisa instead of sending something to the entire group. And so that's helpful if, let's say, you're in the code help session and you're trying to get help for a project, something's not working, someone on Slack might basically reach out to you and send you a direct message to basically help you out. So it's totally up to you how you respond and how you connect with others, but the direct message tends to be a way if you want to be a bit more private. Last thing I want to take a look at is apps. So Slack, one of the nice things is that they basically will have different functionality for you. There's a lot of apps that you can plug in. So you can see that right now I'm using, or this Slack workspace is using Giphy. We're using Google Calendar, Google Drive, Zoom, Twitter, and then GitHub. There are other plugins. There are other apps that you can use. In the past, I've used Trello a lot with the Slack channel. Google Calendar, different things. If this, then that works out really well with Slack. So there's other plugins that you can use because this is a free Slack workspace. You can see that we have a limited number of apps that we can plug in. And an app will just have some functionality. So for the Giphy one, what it can do is I can easily add GIFs to Slack. The thing that I don't really like about it is, so to use the Giphy one, I would basically add that. And then if I look for cats, it will go online and it will look for, as it says, it will find a random or a top cat GIF to share. So I could basically shuffle this. I can try and find a better one. I can send this now to the entire group, or I can obviously cancel it. So the same thing would work if I want to say dogs. It's going to go search and it's going to find different GIFs that might work well for this. I like using GIFs in our messages. I like using it in Slack channels. I think that emoji, emoticons, GIFs can get the message across in a very simple way. The challenge is that some people really don't like it. So for some people, this is very annoying. They prefer text. But then in terms of this Giphy app, another thing that's problematic is it just gives you a couple random choices. I'd rather go to the website itself and see what's out there. So once again, it's a couple higher functioning things to do with Slack. This is by no means the last way to take a look at it. There are a lot of different ways to play with Slack, and ultimately depends on what works best for you. So hopefully that worked out for you. Please leave me a comment down below or a question if there's something that I didn't address. And please subscribe if you haven't already. And hopefully you have a great rest of the day.